Hi everyone, it's Ben Murnane here, one of the editors with Live and Invest Overseas. And I'm here with John Palumbo, who's been with us, working with us, doing presentations at conferences for quite a while. And John, you recently pursued citizenship by ancestry. It is, I suppose, such an interesting journey to go on. Did you find it that way? I mean, you kind of entered this whole world of genealogy and kind of looking back and trying to find those records. It must have been fascinating.
Well, I'll kind of try to take it from the beginning, and you know, stop me at any point, Ben, if you hear something you want to ask me. But for me, after the spark became ignited, I came back and started doing some research for how to actually utilize ancestry. Remember, the gentleman in the front of the room was talking about the more expensive ways. He only saved the last 5 minutes to say the part that got me. And that's, you know, that's the spark that I had been listening for, because he said, if you've got the bloodline, it's a piece of cake. And that was the end of the program. And I talked to him for a few minutes afterwards, and he said, yeah, if you've got the provable bloodlines, he said, you've got the fast access track to the secondary passport and citizenship. So I went to work on it. In doing my homework, there's a lot of companies out there that will help you. They're law firms mostly, or attorneys, or firms that have attorneys with them that will take you through the process. I found that some of them had 1-900 numbers for you to call. And if you're not familiar with what a 1-900 number is, you start paying the minute they answer the phone. 50 cents or a dollar, or maybe even a couple of dollars a minute. And so that way, I guess I understand that they could probably spend endless hours with people on the phone, you know, helping them and not end up doing any business. So there were a lot of companies that did that. Then there were companies that had different fee structures. So I did my homework till I found what I felt like was the most suitable match for me, from their fee structure, how they did it, and everything from there. And as I talked to Ray, and that was a gentleman that helped me, a gentleman named Ray Rapello, and he's with a company called Italme. And he said, well, John, the first thing that we need to do, he said, I've heard your story. And the first thing that we really need to do is run a blueprint. And I said, so tell me what a blueprint is. He goes, well, we've got to make sure that your story of bloodline matches what Italy says is your bloodline. And we'll need to do a blueprint. Basically, it's kind of like a genealogy, but it's not a DNA. I think a lot of people that I've talked to get it confused. Oh, you ran your DNA and found out, you know, where you're from. No, that's really more from a curiosity standpoint. The courts and the judicial system in Italy, and probably like most countries, are not as concerned with your DNA as they are with your ancestry and bloodline that can be proven in those countries through birth records. So for me, I said, okay, and here's what's interesting. I was almost 100% sure we were going to go through my grandfather on my father's side. Right. And that's what I told him. And he says, well, let me get all the information. So I had to fill in a lot of information, such as my mother, my father, and, you know, just what I knew about certain genealogy, which was fairly easy. I'm going to say it took maybe 30 or 60 days to come back with the quote unquote blueprint. And with that, he sent me the blueprint, and he said, I've got good news and bad news. I can remember that day going, what?
Which did you ask for first?
Well, let me ask you, what would you ask for first?
I'm usually a bad news first person.
Okay. Well, that's what I said. Just go ahead and give me the bad news first. Okay. He said, we're not going to be able to use your grandfather for your gateway back to your citizenship. And I was like, but that's impossible. My grandfather came over on the boat, and I can remember his stories of what happened when he got off the boat and how he was treated and unfortunately mistreated and, you know, taken advantage of in many ways. And I said, so I just don't understand, you know, how could this be possible? And he said, I'm going to tell you how it's possible. He said, when your grandfather came over and he had children, your grandfather fought in the war, World War One, and he said, your grandfather rescinded his Italian citizenship 2 years prior to your father being born. What do you mean he rescinded his Italian citizenship?
How can
he
do
gave
that?
It up. He gave it up. And I said, how does he give it up? And he said, it's real simple. He raised his hand and said, I pledge allegiance to the United States of America, as he became a citizen of the United States. And with that, becoming a citizen of the United States, it automatically voided out his Italian citizenship back then.
Right, which isn't the case now, obviously, because you can be a U.S. citizen and an Italian citizen.
Exactly. But by the way, that only occurred in the 90s. Did Italy allow their bloodlines to come back and regain their citizenships? So it's not been there all along. It's just happened in the last few years that this doorway has opened for Italians like myself and my daughter. Mm-hmm. And so he said, so, you know, you're not going to be able to use his bloodline, because when he cut it off, that cut off your bloodline. He said, if your father had been born 2 years prior to him doing that, the line would have been open. And I instantly thought, well, this conversation's about to be over, because if you're wanting to take me down the, we can buy your citizenship by you investing in a $200,000-$400,000 villa and getting a few years under your belt, that's over for me. Mm-hmm. Financially, I'm going to do that.
And right. So I don't think Italy even has a buy real estate and get citizenship option. They have an invest to get citizenship option, but I don't believe real estate is part of it currently, although they are looking at that. So it's interesting.
I mean, if you're going to do that, you might as well, you could pick any country. You know, it's all of a sudden Italy's not important other than because I wanted it. And I said, well, so what is your good news? He says, your great grandmother on your other side of your family never rescinded her Italian citizenship. And I said, you're kidding. He goes, no. He said, so your great grandmother is your gateway back to Italy. And I had no idea that I was going back to my great grandmother on my other side. So this was the value of the blueprint. Mm. So I think a lot of times when people start these journeys, they're like me, you know, we may have been given wrong information or misled, not through anybody's fault, other than storytelling over generation changes from what happened to what didn't happen to who's where and who's not. And I don't even know that my grandfather even realized that he gave up his Italian citizenship, but he never went back. I mean, he came to the United States for a reason, and he stayed here and built a life and a business and had children and, you know, finally retired and died here. Yeah. But he never went back to Italy to any of that. Now, a lot of the family has and gone back to where our roots were. I've gone back to Sicily numerous times, and it was like a journey out of a movie, just going over there and finding my family and taking letters that my grandmother stayed in touch with them all the way up until literally the day she died. So when I went over there for the first time, long before I even considered citizenship, you know, I went back with a stack of letters. And when I went into the small town and village where my grandfather was from, you know, doors were closed, shutters were closed. I'm walking down very abandoned streets until I knocked on a door, because the address lined up with what was on the door. And somebody in a window about a floor or two up looked down and in Italian kind of said, what do you want? I just remember looking up and, you know, I said something in English and they kind of gave me no understanding. And I held the letters up and showed them. And the lady up there, you know, I saw her do this. And then I think she said, Mamma Mia. And she came down, the doors opened. And literally, they squeezed me and hugged me. And, you know, there were a lot of people in there. And they started calling on a landline. This was before the cell phones. When I went over there, my first few trips were many years ago. Mm-hmm. And literally people from that whole village started coming out to see me, and a friend of mine that was there with me, we were traveling together. And it was like out of a movie. The food started getting made, and plates of pastas and meats and breads. And the tables were being loaded up, and they were just bragging, saying, this is our family from America.
Wow.
And I just felt like a king. And I was there for a few days. And as we walked through the streets, the men would put, one arm on each side of me and escort me through the streets as we walked through the streets with men on both sides of me. And that's what men do there at night. They walk and talk until they get to the city centers. But it's as though they were parading me around the city. And it
Wow.
was really an
Celebrity.
experience. It was an experience.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, you're treated like a homecoming king. John, we will include some links for people to get in touch with you with this video. I really enjoyed speaking with you today. Thank you for talking me through the whole story. I know it's going to be fascinating to anyone watching it. Thanks again, and we'll speak to you soon.
My pleasure. And again, if somebody has a question, they're welcome to drop me a line if you're going to include my email address in the links with this. You're always welcome to drop me an email. I travel a lot and I do answer my own email, even though I have a staff of people that work with me. It's my business and what I do. I answer my own email. So you'll enjoy the journey. And all I can say is welcome back home.
Thanks, John.